I want to talk about the Super Bowl because it's coming up this weekend. I know you're a fan of sports. I know you rep the black and gold like I do, big time. But when your team isn't playing, is there someone that you look into to root for? Because we got two dynamite teams in the Super Bowl this weekend. You got your money on anyone?
See, like, when it's, you know, Steelers don't go.
Yeah.
I'm just rooting for, like, people to get stoned.
Okay. So that's a win for everybody involved. Yeah, Team Green.
Yeah. Little party.
Okay. Well, we got the Denver Broncos. We got Cam Newton on the Panthers. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people are classifying him as a black quarterback. But to me, he's just a quarterback who's killing it.
Right.
And so he's responding to that a lot in the media days that have been happening out in San Francisco already. Mm-hmm. Do you have any thoughts on that, on how people want to kind of classify him as such, as rather than just like MVP candidate worthy,
right,
Cam Newton?
I think just the fact that he embraces our culture,
yeah,
and where he's from, as opposed to hiding it.
Yeah.
You know, people try to criticize, but I think it's part of what makes him as popular as he is.
Sure.
Yeah, so he should just rock with it.
He is. I mean, he's even got, like, grandmas in wheelchairs hitting the dab, exactly, out there now in support of him. It's incredible to see how his popularity is taking off.
And it's like, one of my homies was just telling me the other day, was like, man, I remember when Cam came to one of our shows, like, before he was really popular.
Oh, yeah.
And he was just a big, tall-ass nigga in the audience. And, you know, everybody knew he was going to be the man, but
sure,
he's really, really down with the culture and where he's from. So the fact that he doesn't hide it, and, you know, he's got an awesome smile, and he just puts it out there.